Good morning, students. We were discussing question answers of this chapter, My Childhood. So let's continue with the same one. So second, first, why did Abdul Kalam want to leave Rameswaram? What was the reason? That is a very short answer that you have to tell. That why he made a plan? Why did he make a plan that he should leave that space? Why he went? Because Rameswar, it was a very good place. He was feeling comfortable there. But what was that reason that he made up his mind? Yes, now he had to leave that place. Very simple. So who will be telling me this thing? Why he wanted to leave that space? Why he wanted to leave Rameswaram? What was the reason behind that? So I expect this answer from Arzu. Arzu, keep your camera on and give me answer. What was the reason before that? For that, Arzu, you tell me why he wanted to leave that place. Okay, Renuka, you tell me. Renuka, you tell me. Yeah, I don't know why your attendance is going so low. Only 18 out of 47, 18 participants are here in my class. So today I am going to talk each and every absentee's parents why their ward is remaining absent. I just want the answer in written. So Renuka, you tell me. Yes, Renuka, this question is so simple. This question is so simple. What was the reason behind that? Okay, Laksh, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. He wanted to leave Rameswaram for his further studies at headquarters of Ramanthampuram.
Simple answer, yes. Because he wanted to go for higher studies. And in Rameswar, Rameswar was a very simple city. Higher education facilities were not available there. So this was the reason that he wanted to leave Rameswaram. Okay? So next question is, what did his father say to this? What was the response of father when he came to know that Abdul Kalam, he wanted to leave Rameswaram, he wanted to go for higher studies? So what was the, you can say, response of father? Who is going to tell me? It is right given in your books, in last paragraphs. The answer you can find out from last paragraph. What did his father say to this? Sudiksha, you can you tell me this answer? Sudiksha. Sudiksha, can you tell me this answer? Riti Kapoor. Riti Kapoor, can you give me this answer? Kavarnoor. Kavarnoor. Can you tell me this answer? What did his father say to this? See, it is given here in front of you. 11th paragraph. With the help of 11th paragraph, you can frame this answer. With the help of 11th paragraph, you can frame this answer. That when father came to know that...
Yes,
yes, bachche, tell me.
Okay, ma'am. His father says to this that your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of lives along for itself. They come through you, but not for you.
Wrong, completely wrong. Because this was a dialogue given by father to mother. and you are not supposed to write down the same wording from your book, because this line was spoken by father to mother. So you are not supposed to copy those lines. I have given you only hints that by reading, by going through 11th paragraph, you are able to frame this answer very easily. You can frame 11th answer, you can frame last answer very easily by going through 11th paragraph. And your class is not doing well at all. I have to complain all those students, those who are not participating. Only 26 participants are there. And one of the board has started doing annotation on my screen. So that is really bad thing for you. Now tell me, bachche, because in this you are given 11th paragraph, just go through 11th paragraph and see, from this you just make a guess. You just make a guess that when Abdul requested his father, yes, it was a request made by his father, made by his son. So when father listened this thing that yes, his son wanted to go for a higher study, because in Amritsar that was a very simple place and all the facilities were not available there. Okay, so when this urge, this desire was spoken in front of father, so what was the response of father? Did he allow him or not? Tell me, did he allow him or not? How did he react at that situation? He scolded him, he gave him permission. What was the reason for that? Ritika, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. His father said, Abul, I know you have to go away to grow. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without earnest?
Yes, this line, you can little bit mold, and this dialogue was spoken by.
And he gave example of a seagull.
Yes, he gave an example of seagull. Yes, you pick up lines smartly. Don't copy the lines as it is. Pick up those lines that he gave a very good example of seagulls, that when they want to grow, do they go across the sun? They go alone or without a nest? Yes. So by taking a very appropriate example of seagull, he gave permission to his son to go for higher studies in another city. So same answer, Shivansh, you tell me now.
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, yes. Kalam wanted to leave Rameshwaram for further studies after giving his consent to Kalam for pursuing his higher studies in Ramanathapuram. Kalam's father said that he knew Kalam had to go away to grow and follow his dreams. He gave the analogy of a seagull that flies across the sun alone without a nest.
Very good. Now, Renuka, you take a screenshot of these 29 participants. Today, I will talk to the absentees. I will ask their parents that why are their children not attending the classes? English is not a, you can say, important subject for their ward. So you take screenshot and send me today. Okay, now Arzu, your answer is ready or not? Arzu, you tell me your answer. Arzu, what have you written in your answer? Arzu is not responding in class. I don't know what happened to that girl. Earlier, she was doing so well in English class. Aparan, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. His father said that he knew he had to go away to grow. He gave the example of a seagull and said that a seagull flies across the sun alone and without a nest, so you will also have to leave home to grow.
Yes, good. Perfect. Now, same answer I expect from Jayati.
Same. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Kalam's father indirectly expressed his opinion in his words. He gave the example of the seagull to his son, that he trusted his son's decision to grow just like the seagull, their nest to fly across the sun, so the children must be allowed to leave the home and gain knowledge in the big world outside.
Good, perfect one. So you have written this answer in a very nice way. Okay. So his father encouraged him to leave that space. Okay. And he should soar higher and higher. He should touch the zenith. And he gave a very suitable, very apt and appropriate example of seagull, that he told that young seagulls, they also have to leave their parents in order to rise high. Okay. So he gave him permission very nicely by giving suitable example. Now let's move to question number third. What do you think his words mean? Why do you think he spoke those words? First of all, you have to explain the meaning of those words. What was the meaning of those words? It was a very deep meaning, intense meaning, hidden meaning. Okay. See, there are so many human beings, there are so many animals who grow on their own. Okay. After a certain age. So when they grow on their own, it makes them independent. But some are there who nurtured under the protection of mother and father. Okay. So in human also, after a certain time, that you can say proper independence is required by their words. If proper independence, proper liberty, proper freedom will be given to them, only then they can flourish. They can, you can say, face the hard hurdles, face the problems, difficulties in their life. They have to become, you can say, independent. Yes. So it means at one level, a child has to leave his parents, because every time father and mother cannot be with the child. One day they have to leave them so that they can stand on their own. They can take their decision. They can do something in their life. So that is a hidden meaning given in question number third. So this answer I'm going to ask. I'm going to ask this answer from Jayati. After Jayati Kavarnur, then any of the child should be ready.
Yes, ma'am. Kalam's father meant that every human being must be given the opportunity to build his life as per his wishes. The parents should not hinder this effort. The child has to be independent one day to make his own decisions in his life. He spoke those words to convince Kalam's mother that her son's decision to leave the home for higher education was right. She should allow him happily to shape his life according to his own ideas and willingly allow him.
Okay. You have done well. Now, Kavarnur, you tell me, bachcha, the same answer.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Kalam's, he spoken these words because he intended to hone his skills. He knew harsh reality of the life that children may have to live far from their parents and make their career and earn the livelihood. So he shown this wisdom and intelligence in these words.
Your answer is correct, but you just elaborate more. Okay? Otherwise, it is good. Okay. Same answer I expect from Divya.
Yes, ma'am. The words said by Abdul Kalam's father had a deep meaning, that children, after growing up a certain age, need to nurture independently in order to flourish good, so that they had the ability to stand against the hurdle in their life on their own two feet. The Kalam's father words were to convince the mother that their wards should be given an opportunity to build their life like the house is made with a great hard work using single brick.
Good. Very good. You have written so well. Now, bachche. This is the writing part. Think and write a short account of what life in Rameswaram in the 1940s must have been like. Were people rich or poor? Hardworking or lazy? Hopeful or change or resistant to it? So you just start framing this answer. I will be discussing it with you. Okay? Because Second World War was going on. So during Second World War, so what was the condition of Rameswar at that time? Think about this. We are going to discuss about the hints. What was the condition of that? How were people? How were people at that time? They were? Tell me, how were people at that time? They were orthodox? Okay. They were orthodox. You also type in chat box. I'm reading your messages side by side. Okay. Some are writing, some were rich. Okay. Some were rich. Some were rich. Okay. Good. Living with other communities? Living with mixed communities? Yes, living with mixed communities. Good. Yes, how were people? They were hardworking. Yes, they were laborious. They were laborious, hardworking. Yes, some were having stereotypical thinking also. Some were having. They were having stereotypical thinking also. Good. Yes, they were conservative. Very good. So many hints I'm writing here. And I'm reading your chat box also. Yes. Society was divided. Society was divided into different parts. They wanted to abridge the gap. Very good. They wanted to abridge the gap. It means they wanted to make that. Yes. Some were hand to mouth. We can take the example of APJ Abdul Kalam. Some were hand to mouth. Some were hand to mouth. Yes. But cooperative. Very good. They were cooperative. Yes. Optimistic. Religious. Having faith in God. Having faith in God. God fearing. Yes, God fearing. Yes. So these hints, bachche, you can pick up for framing this answer. So with the help of these hints you can keep in front of you. So with the help of these hints, you can frame this answer. So who is going to tell me first? With the help of these hints, who is going to tell me this answer? Now let me see who is ready. only Simran and Dhiren. Let me listen from Dhiren. Afterwards, others all should be ready. I can ask this answer from any of the child. Now 32 participants are there out of 47. It means still 15 are absent. So these 15 absentees will be intimated. So these 32 participants, I'm taking, going to take the screenshot. Okay. Now, Simran, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. According to me, in the year 1940s, the life of Rameshwaram might have been very simple. From the account of Abdul Kalam, people were not very wealthy. Though religious-based segregation existed, people lived in harmony with one another. They were cooperative and very happy together. Still, there were some people who didn't like different social groups to be happy and cooperative together. The religions were demarcated by the clothes they wore or the area they lived in. Like Hindus used to wear a religious thread in their neck and Muslims used to wear a cap, which made them different. Orthodox Hindu Brahmin families were more rigid. The people of the town might have been hardworking, as the author mentions how his cousin used to collect bundles of newspapers for distribution. Kalam's family arranged boat for the visiting pilgrims. Also, the author himself started earning at the tender age of 8 years. Besides, the Second World War might have affected the lives of the people. The author says that India was forced to join the war and subsequently a state of emergency was declared. Indians waited optimistically for independence.
Very good. All the ideas you have arranged so properly, you have picked up almost all the hints. That's really good. Your performance is really praiseworthy. You always participate in class and your answers are always good. So I encourage you, you should always participate like this. Very nice. Good. Now same answer I'm going to ask from Arzu. Now Arzu, are you ready with your answer? Arzu, are you ready with your answer? Tell me. After Arzu, Aditya should be there. Nitya and Ritik should be there with their answers ready. Okay, Arzu, tell me, what have you written?
Yes, ma'am. The residents of Rameshwaram during 1940s were quite orthodox, but very also tolerant of other communities. It has been mentioned in the story that every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific social, economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways of figures of authority. The environment in the Rameshwaram at that time did not allow communal intolerance. They were following their religion seriously and also lived simple without carving for luxuries. The members of the family is very emotional, attached and helpful to each other.
Good. Okay, now here religious and abridged spellings are written wrong by mistake. So, bachcha, you correct these spellings. Religious, R-E-L-I-G-I-O-U-S. I have provided you hints only. So, after that, I just want to ask, Aditya is ready with his answer? Renuka is moving somewhere. Renuka, what is the emergency? What happened? She was driving, I think so. Okay, Aditya, you tell me this answer. Renuka, you don't take risk. You are driving and attending the class. Don't take this risk. You can watch this recording later on. If you have any emergency to go somewhere, So you can watch this later on. It will be shown. Yes, Renuka was driving somewhere, I know. Okay, now I expect this answer from these boys will never raise hands in class. Now some of the boys have left to whom I have told give the answer. Aditya, Ritik, Nitya. Okay, Arzu, now you can give me answer. Yes, Arzu.
Mama, I have given. Actually, I was that earlier it was not unmuting. There was no option.
Okay. Now, Aditya, you tell me this answer. Aditya. Aditya is not responding. Mitansh. These students will be marked absent by me today. Those who are not responding in class at all, Aditya and Mitansh. Nitya. Nitya, tell me your answer.
Yes, ma'am. During the 1940s, people lived together of different communities. Some were rich, some were poor. Hindus and Muslims also lived in harmony and in the same community. But there were some people who did not wanted to. Many people wanted to abridge the gap of the religious gap between Hindus and Muslims. Many people were cooperative and optimistic, and also people were religious and had faith in God, and they were hardworking.
Okay, you tried your level best. Otherwise, it was okay. Now, afterwards, Ashmeet Paul. Ashmeet, you tell me this answer. Ashmeet. Yes, Ashmeet. Your answer is ready or not? Ashmeet, what have you written? From tomorrow onwards, it will be very much compulsory to keep your camera on. The students who will not be keeping their cameras on during English class, they will be marked absent by me. I'm not making this rule for today. From tomorrow onwards, you all should keep your camera on, so that I can come to know that are you writing it side by side? Are you participating in class or not? Only in this way, if you participate, if you keep your camera on, I will mark you present. Otherwise, you will be marked absent by me. And today I'm going to talk to all the absentees, and they have to mention the reason. They have to write down an application and mention the reason why are they not attending class of English regularly. I'm going to make a list today. Okay? I'm going to make a list today. Now tell me. Now tell me, hurry up. Okay, Shivansh, what have you, Jaskirat, what have you written in this answer? Jaskirat, what have you written? Jaskirat, this class is not responding. Their performance is going so down. I know they are doing drama. Okay, Nitish, you tell me this answer. Nitish, Ekjot. Ekjot, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Only then you will be marked present by me if you give me suitable answer. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. In 1940, the life in Rameshwaram seems to be in dilapidated condition. Most of them lead a poor life, having very, very simple livelihood. A very few can be among the rich people. The means of education were scanty. They worked hard in earning a small coin, which used to be of great worth in those days. They belonged to orthodox views, but there was no racial differences whatsoever. They were from hand to mouth, and they only afford the essentials of life. People had cooperation among them. They were hopeful of having changes in their moods. They were hardworking, and they were having faith in God. They were God-fearing.
Good, very good. Now, Ritik, you just tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. In 1940s, the life in Rameshwaram was very difficult. Some people were rich, some people were poor. Some were living with the mixed communities, and some of them having stereotypical thinking. And all were hardworking laborers, and all were having faith in the God, and some were all religious and cooperative.
Good. We will come. Okay, you are supposed to do all these questions in your fair notebook, and tomorrow we will be doing one of the writing skill. And similar, whatever the query you are having, you can call me after the class. Okay, we will be solving about your query. Okay, I know you want to ask about that competition. We will discuss about after the class on phone. So by the time, now time is running out, I have to over my class. And you all should be, you can say, all should attend your classes regularly. The students who are irregular, who are not responding in class, they are making fun in class, their names are being given in the office, and very soon you will be called here. And you have to be answerable and tell the reason why are you not attending the classes regularly. Because if you remain absent for more than 2-3 days, your name is given in the office. Okay, students, now thank you and have a nice day. Do question answer of this chapter in your fair notebook.